Welcome back. We're glad you're watching The Business Show. Feel free to drop the comments in the meantime. Like I keep saying, the conversation continues now, after the show, or even before the show. Just keep telling us what you think about the business program and how are you faring. I did talk to a friend who is more into business rescuing in the WhatsApp country. He told me, man, times are hard. Businesses are struggling, but most of them lack basics of how to succeed. And I think it's important that we facilitate them to understand. When I talk about facilitation, sometimes it doesn't have to be money per se. It can be advise them on how to handle their workers. Should they downsize? Should they not restock? Things like that can still help your business stay afloat. Yeah? Talking businesses staying afloat, let's run you through the last episode then of Violet's visit, or the visit to Violet's farm in Wakiso. And it is on how to make money this week. And we are talking how she's making money from sugarcane processing, plus making some hair oil as well. That and more in her final story of how to make money.
Okay, my name is Kazwe George. So I'm going to show you the process how to make the sugarcane juice. Before we make the sugarcane juice, we first make sure that we get the order. Mm. So when we if you don't have orders, you can't make the sugarcanes, because when you purchase or you buy the sugarcanes and put there without order, they can
get spoiled. All right. So thank you so much for speaking to us. Let's start from there. So when you get the orders, you said you go to the market and you buy the ingredients. And what are those ingredients that you buy?
First, the sugar canes.
Okay.
Second, onion. Second, lemon. Hmm. Second, lemon. And ginger.
Okay.
And mulondo. Hmm. Then, after getting them, after collecting all of the ingredients, we start doing how to make the sugarcane juice. At first, we make sure that everything is clean. You wash your hands before you make the sugarcane juice. Mm. You make sure that you are clean. You wash your hands and make sure that you put on the you're dressing smartly, then you start. By starting things, you have to wash the dust on the sugar canes. Mm. And other ingredients like ginger,
the lemon.
Lemon.
And then the mulondo.
And then the mulondo.
Okay. So basically we are washing to avoid having dirty stuff in the machine, but also the product itself must be clean.
Yeah.
Okay. So how then do we move from there after we're done washing? What next?
Next, the process of cutting, like chopping. Yeah.
That's with a knife.
With the knife, okay. In pieces. Mm. So that you can fix it inside and start to drilling.
Okay. How good is that juice? Like when I say good, like how nutritious is it, or is it of any use to the body in terms of health? Is it good for the body?
It's good because everything we use, yeah? Mm. It is from
that organic.
Very organic, and
it's who are mostly your clients? Which people make orders mostly?
So the consumers of this juice are health conscious people. Those who want to lose weight, those who want to maintain weight, those who want to, for kids, boosting their immunity, because it's rich in vitamin C from the lemon. It's good for the virility of the men, supposedly, that is purported.
Yeah,
but mainly for people who want to boost the immunity of their children, and also those who want to, the people who go to the gym, who are health conscious, they take that, the sugarcane juice, because of the lemon and the ginger.
Okay.
Yeah. So it's packed in 5 liters, 3 liters. That is the main way we pack it. But we also have customers who want the 1 liter and the half liter. Those who take the 5 liter and the 3 liter, we deliver for free within Kampala and the surrounding areas. Those who take the smaller packages, they have to pay for the transportation. So for now, that is the mode we use for the marketing. Yes, we have thought of opening like outlets, but for now it doesn't seem viable because of the financial implications, but it's something we'll look at in the future.
Okay.
Yeah, so basically that is it.
Maybe one of the things that the production capacity for the machine, how I know because we talked about what 1 hour for 10 liters. That's manually, yeah.
Yes, but is a manual. It's a manual machine. Like I said, we've just been 6 months into production. We are looking to, once production
shoots higher,
we'll get a motor that is connected here, and then we can produce more juice in a day. But as the production stands for now, it is not financially viable. We make profit, yes, but like I say, a business must sustain itself. If it's not going to buy the motor itself, we will move as is.
So you can't pick money for chicken and bean pudding here?
I already got the money to buy the equipment from there. So now the baby must learn to walk and run. Otherwise, it will forever be a baby. And it must pay. It has paid back. Yeah, like even for the mushroom, we got from there. But it must pay back. Otherwise, you keep, and then the chicken will suffer. Yeah. Yeah, that is like where I say people have their jobs and they forever get from money from the job to sustain a business. It's not viable. Now, when you have a business that is doing well and you suck it, soon you will have nothing.
Okay, so talk to us about the inspiration. Oh, yeah, what really inspired you to start this?
Again, all of it in a bit to diversify thanks to COVID. But once you start it, you find that people appreciate. So it also encourages you to move. You find, well, I took like an oil, it worked for me. The hair is smoother and it's no longer itching. Yeah, so you're like, hey, it's working and it's working well. Why not continue? So yeah, that's what has kept me going. Yeah, it's been well received by the market.
And what does your production capacity look like now?
We produce about 20 bottles a month.
Okay.
Yeah. For now.
You decided to go small. Why?
Yeah. Why? I do not want to hold all the capital in. So when we actually, like even with the juice, when people place orders is when we make. Otherwise you're going to make something and it sits. So we want to first build the market. People now tell their friends about it. When it works for one person, then they tell their friend like that. So it's we are marketing mainly through referrals and social media. So it's been about 6 months with this. So I don't see why it would make so much when people have not yet learned about the product. Yeah.
Okay. So I know you talk about diversification, but don't you feel at one point you lose track of everything because you have then enough? How do you balance all that?
I have help and have records. So if you have records, it's easier to manage. And again, this is still young. I'm not in a rush to just see it like from the hen business. I rushed and almost crashed. If it were not for perseverance, I would have given up. So I do not want to experience the same. I'm taking my time with it. I'll make on order and people will buy there. I'm not keeping my capital. I'm not stressed about, oh, I've made so much. I tell you, I'm not to be tambula. No, I don't want that stress. I'm diversifying, yes, but I'm taking it slow. It will grow. organically.
So for the last 1 month, we've been talking a visit to Violet's farm in Wakiso, from poultry to mushroom, now sugarcane and hair oil. I don't know what you learned, but as a business person, if an aspiring business person or entrepreneur, I know for a fact that you've learned something. So sit back, draft your budget and see what you can get into. If you need some expert thoughts, get into, you know, our socials and let us know. We'll connect you up with those who are doing it okay, so you can learn from them and see how you can better yourself. It is from the different people that have made it that some of us that want to start should be able to start. Yeah, so don't worry, just feel free to get in touch with us. We'll help you link up with Violet or any other person that has featured on this show and help you improve your business. Let's then talk about personal finance tips for this week. If you made the money, you need to see how to manage it. And week three of our month-long series with Tamale Augustine, who is the Chief Finance Officer of Vision Group, or New Vision, we are talking precautions before taking a loan. The basics that you need to understand, here they are. Take a look.
Hello, viewer. Augustine Tamale, my name is Chief Finance Officer of Vision Group, and we are handling the issue of borrowing or loans. We did see the terms you need to look at to understand whether your loan is good. So you need to look at those terms thoroughly. Don't rush to sign. Look at those terms and be sure that you can manage them. The loan installment size fits in your income, at most 50%, but try to lower it to 40 or 30% of your income. That's when you live a comfortable life, not a life of deep thoughts when a loan has become a problem. The other issue is that you needed to look at the early settlement provision that exists, such that you can do away with the loan. Never carry a loan full term. In my life, I always clear my loans earlier, usually half the period. I clear them off and I move on. So loans have been helping me to acquire land, build, and so on. Get a vehicle, but I clear earlier. Otherwise, you drive a vehicle, it's expensive to maintain, and also servicing a loan for many years, it becomes a problem. You may end up selling even the car. So you should always have a plan to settle your loans earlier. All borrowings should go in that regard, and several other terms to look at, including the early settlement option, which should be available for you at not more than 18%, and the interest rate, a sensible one, 18 to 23%. Above that is terrible, but let's work on lower ones in our credit cooperatives. And as more banks come up, the competition will be intense and the interest rate will come down. Today we need to look at other precautions you need to take when borrowing. The first one is the frequency of your income. The frequency of your income. Some people have irregular income. This month you can earn money, the next month you earn nothing. So when you are computing your earnings, you should be able to take an average of how much you earn in half a year, in 6 months. What do you earn? You should know that. That for you, you are not on a monthly income. That is very important. So don't take a loan which enforces a monthly installment if your income is irregular. It should be a longer period, say quarterly or twice a year. That's when you service. That will help you out. It should have that good term for you in order to collect money to pay your loan installment. But still, in that irregular income, for some people it's the timing, but for other people it's even the amount. So this month you earn 3 million, next month 500 million. You may be a businessman, so it keeps oscillating. You should also take an average. Don't go for an excess amount that you can't handle. So work out the irregularity in timing, but also the irregularity in the amounts. That is very, very important. The other issue you should look out for is the reputation of your financial institution. Don't go to a financial institution that literally almost all its borrowers end up in court or end up having their assets liquidated or they end up in prison. Don't go for such a financial institution because its priority may be to acquire your property. So look out for the history of that institution before you deal with it. There are institutions that have been charging especially low-end people beyond what they agreed upon. So those institutions that charge you more months, the loan is for 2 years and they end up in 3 years and people are complaining. That is a terrible institution. Don't borrow from it. Borrow from institutions that have clear track records of how they have succeeded in uplifting people's financial situation. The other matter you should look out for is whether the law, the institution just pushes for restructuring or rescheduling. The two differ because restructuring changes the terms of the loan. It can put you at a higher installment. Like when we were in the times of the COVID-19 pandemic, some institutions went for restructuring whereby your loan became bigger. You didn't pay for some months, maybe 6, maybe 4, and the loan became bigger. You had a loan of 100 million and it became 150 million. They kept charging interest and it built up. But rescheduling moves the installment to another month and is just a small penalty added. So those two issues must be looked into because after they have restructured the loan, it becomes too big for you. You can't handle it. And this has happened to several individuals who have had to liquidate even the projects that they had invested in because the loan was too big beyond their means. So you do away with the project and rescue your financial health. So those are things you must look into to be sure that your loan is able to fit in your financial aspirations and your financial capacity. If you don't look into those matters, you borrow your future away. You are somebody who has worked for several years. At the end of those years, you have nothing. You simply worked for financial institutions. Also, look into the agreement you are signing. Is it a sale of property? Is it a borrowing? Some people don't have permission to lend, and therefore, the agreement signed are for sale of property. So you end up signing an agreement that you are selling your piece of land or house to that individual who is lending you. That's what the agreement reads. Check the agreement properly. Don't rush for the amount of money. Don't rush for that. First, go through the agreement and understand which type of transaction are you getting into. When you just sign, you will have a problem. Besides, you may need witnesses to help you out because two are better than one. Someone will look through and tell you, no, this is a wrong agreement. So don't rush. Look through your borrowing agreement with another individual who will advise you, and that will help you to get a good borrowing.
Augustine Tamale there with the tips for you, all the precautions that you need to take before you take a loan. And it's important that you consider them, because ask yourself how much you'll be paying. Does the loan allow you to pay? Is it flexible enough to pay before all the number of months or years you've agreed on? And what is the total interest? And in the event that you have defaulted, What will the penalties be? Those are some of the things you need to pay attention to before you take a loan. I keep saying do not, and I repeat, do not take loans out of excitement. Sometimes loans are taken out of need, but the paying time becomes harder because you probably now feel you've sorted your problems and you do not have the money to pay back. So if you want to take a loan, take your time and analyze all the basics that Augustine has shared with us. You should be able to get through it, yeah? Let's run you through the Forex and the money markets. I saw NSSF getting about 31 billion from MTN in dividends. Good stuff. Here's the Forex and money market report. Well, I guess I have to go now. Thank you so much for making time and watching the Business Show. Feel free to get in touch with us on what you think about the program or what you want to learn as well. If there's anything that is not clear, we're here down at Vision Group. Get in touch with us. We can be more than glad to speak with you and help you grow your business. For guys in Bali, we hope you're having fun at the expo. Yes, pass through and learn one of the things on how you can, you know, run your business. Plus also shout out to there's a new project that has been launched that is aimed at skilling and mentoring innovators. The way to go. My name is Simon. I'll see you soon. Bye bye.